So we're going to finding percentages there using the Z-scores. We've used Z-scores last two classes. Now we're going to use how they're actually made to work out percentages and then, of course, probabilities after that. So one of the things that is not commonly known is that when, especially in universities and even at my old high school, teachers would grade on a bell curve. That would mean that if you got an 80%, you might get an A. If you got a 50% as a fail or 40% as a fail, you might get a D, because it was all the grading was done on what's called the curve. And the curve is this bell curve here, this bell shape that this normal curve looks like. And it is interesting because if we look at the levels at the end here, what the bell curve says is that of all the kids taking a test, only 2% would perhaps be given an A. Now, this can change depending on what the teacher was like. But at the other end, only 2% would get an F. Now, if you had 100 kids taking a test, for instance, that would mean that only 2 would get an A, and, of course, 2 would only get an F. Now, where does this sort of fall down? Well, it falls down in the fact that you might have 3 kids at the top of your class who are all pretty much the same. Come the exam, they get scores within 1% or 2% of each other, but only 2 of them will get A's. The third one gets a B. So where is the curve like this used most of all? Well, this would be used in big, big studies, like in like your IB exams sometimes. IB exams, you'll have thousands and thousands of kids taking the exam. And it guards against maybe a harder exam one year or an easier exam the next year. So what you don't want is to have an easy exam and everybody scores above 90%, pretty much like a data management test with me, isn't it? And the other end, you don't want a very hard exam where all the kids, nobody gets higher than 70%. So you have to introduce this idea of a bell curve where a certain percentage will get A's, certain percentage B's, a much bigger percentage C in the middle, and then your D's and F's. So the question here says, the lineup for a concert had a mean time of 20 minutes and a standard deviation of 4. What percentage of people waited 29 minutes or more? So the formula we're going to usually we're going to work around is the same formula we had before, which was that Z equals X minus the mean divided by standard deviation. So most of these questions now, we're going to work out a Z-score. Let's help work out what the Z-score is for this 29 minutes of data. So we know 29 minus the mean, when mean was 20, I'm going to divide that by 4. So we get 9 divided by 4, which is 2.25. Now we know that on a bell curve, on a normal curve, the curve's going to look something like this. We know the mean runs down here, and 2.25 is going to be about here. That's going to be about 2.25. And we're looking for the percentage of people that waited more than 29 minutes, because we know the average was 20 here, and the data point we got is 29. So we're looking for that average above. So 0.98978, which equates to 98.978%. And we don't forget that percentage is the percentage that lies to the left of our data point. So we want the other end, so we're going to do 100 minus that. And we get a very small percentage, which is equal to 1.022%. So about 1% would end up waiting for 29 minutes or more. So on a recent math exam, the mean was 72%, the standard deviation was 7. Big Mike scored 88%, but needed to be in the top 3% to get a scholarship. So the same thing we're going to do is the same formula. So we know that Z equals the data point minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. So we're going to find out the Z score for Big Mike here. So we know his data point was 88. The mean was 72, and the standard deviation was 7. So that's 16 divided by 7 is 2 point something. And that something is 2.285, so 2.29 we'll call it for this, for purposes like this. Now, the question says it needs to be in the top 3%. So we're looking at our graph, our bell graph. The top 3% would be this bit here, which means that this bit must be 97%. And that's all done. And if we go back to this one here, the z-score of 1.885 is going to be here, or round about there. There's the mean. So this score here that we've got of Big Mike, which was 2.29, is definitely in between, inside the 3%. So the answer is yes, he did get his scholarship money. Well done, Mike. So we go to our z-tape. Our standard normal distribution table, and we're looking for 2.25. There's 2.2, and 0.05 is up there, so we want to come down until we find 2.2, and we go across, and we're looking for that number there, 98778, find on this sheet here. So you're going to search through this whole sheet and find the nearest number to 97%. And 97% equals 0.97. So which number is closest to 0.97? Is that one and that one? It's going to be halfway in between each one. So it's going to be 1.8. And halfway would be 85. So 1.885 would be the z-score that equates to 3%. And 2.5 is going to be, 2.5 is there, so that's our answer there, so 0.99379. So we've got a graph, and we're looking for 97%. So 97% is what we're looking for, which is a value of 0.97. So somewhere on here, we've got 0.97, and 0.97, I think we've done this already before, haven't we? Excuse me, it's 97.7, so it's 977 we're looking for. So we're looking for 977, we go along, and we get, in fact, there's one there, and one there. That's 97725, that's 97670. This one's closer, which is 2.0 and 1.99. So if we went for 1.995, i.e. halfway between those two, we get probably what we're looking for. So 1.95, see there's 2.0 there. 1.99 is there, so halfway would be 1.995. That's our z-score. Important. So another good question. An Oreo factory makes biscuits that weigh an average 40 grams with a standard deviation of 2 grams. Oreo biscuits are thrown out if they weigh more than 45 grams. Oh, some nice cookies get thrown away there. What percentage are thrown out? So again, we're back to our same formula. We know that z equals the data point minus the mean over the standard deviation. So we've got to work out the z value for this lot here. So we know that the data point is 45 minus 40 over the standard deviation 2. So we've got 5 over 2 is 2.5. So we need to go to our z-score and find 2.5. By question, we know that the z-score, the percentage for that z-score is 0.99379. And that equals 99.379%. Remember, the question is asking for the ones that weigh more than 45. So we know that there's the mean at 40. There's the cutoff point. Everything else, these are the ones that are thrown out greater than 45. And we know this value is the percentage underneath. So, of course, we've got to do 100 minus that. We get 0. If I do my maths right, 0.621%. So about 0.6% of Oreos made weigh more than 45 grams and thrown out. Last question here. Speed of cars on highways, mean of 95, a standard deviation of 5. The police stopped 2.3% of all speeding cars. And what is the exact speed limit the police will stop? It's a tough question. It's the 2.3% we're interested in. We know that if we look at the graph, this is the mean here at 95. So the police, these are the ones that break the speed limit. These are the ones that stop. Is 2.3%. And if we do some subtraction here, we know that this percentage here is going to be this value minus 100, so 97.7%. 97.7% to the left of the value, the speed we're looking for. So we go, so we know that z equals x minus the mean over the standard deviation. And we know that 1.995 is our z-score. We know the data value is what we're trying to find. The mean is 95, and the standard deviation is 5. So we cross-multiply here, and we get 5 times that, which is 9.975. X minus 95. So we take the 95 to the other side and we get 104.975. So we could probably round that up to 105 is kilometers per hour is the speed. We're above that. The police will stop you.